Wow, okay. So I was planning on making this video for kind of a long time now, but I'm honestly just kind of stunned at how quickly this progressed and how it progressed. I'm glad now that I waited all this time to make a video like this because oh boy, did this drama get spicy real quick. There's a lot of points to hit on and a lot to go over, so without further ado, let's just jump into it. I mentioned some of these points in past videos, but I'll be digging into more recent developments as well. So yeah, let's just start out with a quick recap of everything. Susie Lou is a channel with nearly 300,000 subscribers, and she does gaming and reaction videos. Her reaction videos aren't really reactions, it's more just her going ooh and ah every few minutes while a full episode of anime plays in the corner. The opacity is lowered to avoid copyright bots picking it up, which already is sketchy on its own, but Susie swears up and down she's not doing anything wrong, however that's obviously not the case, and even though she knows that, we'll get into that later. This all started after she copyright struck a video a while ago that was so blatantly fair use it's painful to see her response. There was an interview conducted with a lawyer who said the video was fair use, and then the video with the lawyer was taken off YouTube for bullying and harassment. It's literally an interview. Her response to the whole situation has been less than great to say the least, and I'll go over it later, but right now I'll give you guys a quick look into recent developments in the situation. So in Susie's response video, she called Tipster News a harasser and a cyberbully. Tipster is kind of a big name in the situation, but this is pretty strange as Tipster has never once harassed anyone, and there's been some past dirt dug up on Susie regarding her actions towards another user called Becky Boop, as well as some bad opinions towards McDonald's workers. However, let's take a look at some of these past tweets. Usually bringing up someone's past isn't something I do, but personally finding this information, it's been very relevant considering her claims that Tipster is a cyberbully. Let's read this tweet here, saying, "If you put as much effort into losing weight as you do talking trash online, then you might actually be pretty fat a gamer, hashtag attention whore." That's interesting, Susie. You're talking about someone's weight, calling them ugly and fat, that almost sounds like you're going after someone's physical appearance. But you're so quick to call someone measuring your forehead cyberbullying and harassment. You know, that's how going after someone's physical appearance is so disgusting, you apparently did the same thing to someone else? In an interview with Tipster, Becky revealed that her weight was in large part due to medication she was taking and not a lot more could have been done about it. Not only that, but Becky also went on the record saying that Susie's harassment of her was so bad that she quit YouTube. Bullying someone to the point where they leave a platform, shaking my head. It could almost be argued that Susie going after people's videos talking about her is also harassment, as the definition of harassment is, quote, aggressive pressure or intimidation. Repeatedly striking down people's videos critiquing you sounds pretty aggressive and intimidating, not to mention this tweet here where she continues to shame Becky for her weight, saying, she's considering her options, so there's the gym, liposuction, eating less, so many options, a quirky tongue out emoji. It's so massively hypocritical for her to act like she's a victim by getting her forehead measured and having some jokes thrown at her when she literally harassed this girl for a problem she couldn't control, and even went as far as to make fun of Becky when she landed in the hospital due to an allergic reaction. In the description of this video that's now been deleted, she says, "What I do when I'm not eating, I found out I was allergic to health food, so I'm going back to Big Mac." Not only does that not make sense, in her interview with Tipster, Becky says her hospital trip had nothing at all to do with her weight and, again, was an allergic reaction to a medication, if I recall correctly. Susie even admits to sending her friends and subscribers to mass dislike Becky's channel and refuses to tell her, saying, quote, "It's all in the past," and she's, quote, "not going to rat on her friends." Doesn't Becky at least deserve to know who did that to her? I quite agree with her response here, saying that, quote, "fucking with someone's channel is something you don't do." This happened in the past, but as of the making of this video, Susie hasn't apologized for it, at least as far as I know. I'm not sure if they did make amends in the past, but I do know Susie leaked an email where Becky did try to squash the beef, although I'm not sure if the advance was reciprocated or not. Okay, so I'm sorry for yet another segment about Twitter, but I feel like this is too good of an opportunity to pass up. This news recently broke, but it's been revealed that Susie is still on board with making fun of people's weight. Recently, too, so it's not like she's changed ever since the whole Becky Boop thing went down, no. She's just not being as overt with it. In this tweet, Susie says, "It's almost as if Tipster is massively insecure or something. It's all fun and games when you engage in targeted harassment on the attributes I can't change, but when a guy laughs at the thought of Tipster running, that's a step too far, lol, rolling eyes emoji." Listen, Susie, it's not that making fun of someone's weight is a step too far, but it's the part where you're flagging people's videos down over jokes of a similar caliber, but feel it okay to say the same type of things to other people is where we have a problem. You have made similar jokes in the past, you're condoning similar jokes against other people now, but as soon as someone takes a tape measure to that noggin of yours, it's suddenly disgusting and wrong. You can't cry targeted harassment when something happens to you, but turn around and condone and participate in the same behavior yourself. If you hadn't pissed yourself over the forehead jokes, maybe this wouldn't have been that big of an issue, but come on, you're 30 years old acting like a 10-year-old who just got into their very first DeviantArt drama. Practice what you preach, or stay away from petty insults altogether. Now, this isn't exactly the most relevant or important topic, but I feel it does a good job of highlighting how egotistical and hypocritical Susie is. She tweeted out this gem regarding McDonald's strike, saying, "McDonald's workers on strike because they want £10 an hour? Go get an actual decent job and stop expecting handouts." An actual decent job? Stop expecting handouts? Like, you have an actual job yourself. Susie, you do realize being a YouTuber who barely reacts to anime isn't a job. Literally, all you do is sit your ass down and stare blankly at a screen for 20 minutes a day, and then you reap the rewards from it. Please, you steal the hard-earned money from animators, editors, and voice actors of the people behind the anime, and then you shit on people trying to make an actual living? Being a YouTuber can be a job, but it's only sustainable if you have a decent following, and it's only respectable when you put effort into your content. Unlike you, whose only claim to fame is being that one girl who re-uploads anime and reports people who criticize her. Not exactly the best reputation to have. People who work at McDonald's likely aren't in the best place either, so it makes no sense to shit on them for wanting more pay. Also, isn't having a Patreon literally just asking for handouts? You get money handed to you on a silver platter with barely any effort, and you try to talk down to people that make an honest living. I sure hope you don't go to fast food restaurants, because if this is how you think of their workers, you shouldn't be using the services they provide. Just throwing my opinion out there, if you don't respect people in customer service, you best not be using their services. You don't get to talk down to the same people who make your burger, bag your groceries, or deliver your food. Retail isn't the best job out there, but as we're seeing now, it's a highly essential one, so just give the employees the respect they deserve. Oh my, Susie has gotten herself into a spot of trouble recently. Her channel has been hit with over 100 copyright claims, all from a third party. Now, in case you didn't know, only companies and huge YouTubers can copyright claim someone anonymously. So this is most definitely not someone who's simply trolling, as she so claims. Susie says in this tweet that she just woke up to an email from a copyright troll who has struck all my channels and threatens to continue to do so until I do what they are demanding me to. I love the smell of blackmail in the morning, rolling eyes emoji. Now, you can understand why I made a website, business as usual. I'm sorry, but how exactly is anime companies claiming your videos, which aren't fair use, blackmail? I'm pretty sure the only thing these corporations are demanding you to do is stop re-uploading their content. I find the last line about her website very interesting, seeing as it was also recently discovered that Susie's website was using a host that ignores DMCAs. This is the same host 8chan used, and thanks to John Swan on Twitter for bringing this to our attention, as well as Twitter user John Doe Iyer, I'm sorry I can't pronounce that, for digging it up. Now, this doesn't mean Susie's completely immune to DMCA takedowns, it just means that the middleman is cut out and anime companies now need to come for Susie directly instead of the website host taking action for them. Susie even knows what she's doing isn't fair use. Taking a look at her Patreon, it was recently scrubbed of most of its content. Susie left her loyal patrons a message, which is pretty lengthy, however, I want to focus on the last paragraph specifically, the part that reads, "As for the videos moving forward, the VIP will not have to worry about the videos being transparent, but they will have edits. While this might disappoint some, it's to keep in line with fair use, and it keeps the companies happy too. It also means I get to continue to create reaction-based content that you guys love." To keep in line with fair use, huh? So your videos before weren't fair use. Very interesting. I thought you and your lawyer boyfriend, who never went to the law school, weren't in the wrong. Crazy how things turned out. I love how she tries to claim that Mark's clip, which was reviewed and approved by a lawyer, like an actual lawyer, that wasn't fair use, but she just flat out admits that she wasn't within fair use before. I don't know how the hell she just lies constantly. Like, does she actually think people will take her words at face value and not dig deeper, or has she actually deluded herself into believing her own lies? Either way, she really just needs to stop and take a step back for a while before she gets herself into even more hot water. Alright, so I just finished recording this video when I caught wind of this, and thankfully I was too busy playing Animal Crossing to edit, so here I am back with another little segment. As of the moment of writing this, May 5th, Susie's Patreon is currently under review by the Trust and Safety team. There's no doubt in my mind that this recent situation has something to do with it, and whether or not her page will be reinstated is currently up in the air. In Patreon's TOS, there is a section about authenticity and copyright, which reads as follows. Patreon is for creators who put something original out into the world. As a creator, you may not post creations that infringe on others' intellectual property rights. Now, the subsections of this block don't go into much detail, so I'll hop on over to the copyright policy so generously linked at the bottom of this stub, which says, Patreon's policy is to terminate, in appropriate circumstances, subscribers and account holders who are repeat infringers. We rely on creators to fund, post, or link only to their own original creations on our platform and to notify us when creations are being misused, stolen, or otherwise abused. When creations are being misused, that sounds a lot like what Susie's doing. I don't know about you guys, but selling videos where 81% of it is just uncut anime sounds a lot like misuse of content to me. It's been proven that a lot of Susie's Patreons are only there for the anime, which is taking away market from the original distributors, which is a key factor in defining if something is fair use or not. If the target audience for your content is the same as the target audience for the original creator, it's not fair use, or it's less likely to be fair use. For example, me. I react to and critique gachatubers a lot, thus my target audience is not people who want to watch gacha videos, rather people that want to see gacha videos getting critiqued. As for the actions that could be taken if the team finds Susie's Patreon to break TOS, it says here that, quote, termination is usually reserved for repeat infringers. Now, it's unclear to me if repeat infringement means breaking TOS multiple times on the same account, breaking TOS or evading bans on different accounts, or both. If it's both or the first option, Susie's probably fucked because her entire channel was just a big mass of copyright infringement. If it's the latter, Susie has a chance to reform her content depending on how strict the rule is. In short, Susie Lou is a liar, hypocrite, abuser of the copyright system, and seems to be favored by YouTube due to her channel being falsely reinstated a while ago. She may have been taking steps in the right direction by editing her videos, but the extent of those edits have yet to be observed. My advice to her would be to improve your reactions by giving some in-depth critique or opinion about the story of the anime, the direction the plot is going in, and the animation or your personal observation of the characters, and if you can't do that, just quit reactions and stick to gaming, because stealing from anime companies like that isn't very cool. Or legal. That does it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.